in the Cavern Centre and in the Town Hall, and we've now got this one out in the street. Can I say thank you all for coming along, and I hope it stays dry for the rest of the evening, and I hope the dolphin does well out of our attendance here this evening. This is a campaign at one level about the Labour Party leadership, but another level it's about a lot of other things. We entered this campaign, and I hope we keep the wires on the microphone. Yes, we're there. And I want to say, first of all, big thank you to the FBU for giving us this facility this evening, for the work that all firefighters do all the time. Keep yourself safe, and for the best slogan ever, we rescue people, not banks. Thank you. Of the Labour Party, but it's also about an alternative. When we lost the election in May, all of us were pretty devastated by that defeat, obviously. We were devastated at what the possibilities were for the future, and there was some good stuff in that Labour manifesto. But I believe the fundamental problem was that the banking crisis of 2008-09 was not caused by firefighters, street cleaners, nurses, teachers, or any services. It was caused by deregulation, it was caused by speculation, it was caused by sheer levels of greed. And whilst taking the banks into public ownership was absolutely the right thing to do, the problem was they weren't kept in public ownership, the banks weren't forced to work for the rest of and the rest of the economy, they were allowed to carry on their own sweet way. So when we got to the 2010 election, we were offering more austerity, more cuts, more punishment on the poorest in this country. David Cameron claimed we're all in it together. I don't think so, David Cameron. I don't think we're all in this together at all. I think you think everybody else is in it together, except you and your party and the people around you. So we then have had 5 years of opposition. We've seen what the coalition government has done. The numbers of jobs that have been lost in the public sector, the wage freeze, the lower wages for those in the private sector, the zero-hours contracts, the brutality of much of the benefit system and what it's doing to the poorest and most vulnerable within our society. So when we came to the 2015 election, we should have been able to offer something other than austerity and saying that we believe the function of government is to deal with the poorest in our society and ensure that poverty is eliminated and promote an economy that is expanding with jobs opportunities and growth for all, without the process of austerity. And so we entered this leadership contest in order there could be that debate and that alternative. And the response has been truly amazing. The thousands of people that have come out to take part in this discussion, saying things about the kind of society they want to live in. If I asked you all to raise your hands if you supported healthcare as a human right, free at the point of use, every single hand was going up, even though 1-3 rows in from the back was slightly slow in raising their hand, it's okay. Yes, we will support that, and we recognise what an incredible achievement it was for the Labour movement when we got the NHS in 1948, before I was born. We also, the same year, got the welfare state. But somewhere along the line, we've lost our way. Somewhere along the line, we join in Benefit Street, we join in abuse of people who are justly